Before the test began, the SENCON device was calibrated. The sand cone container was filled with Ottawa sand and covered with a funnel. Its mass is recorded. The base plate was placed on a clean, flat surface and the sand cone device was placed inverted over the base plate. The funnel valve was opened to fill the base plate and funnel. Once filled, the valve was closed and the device was removed from the base plate. The mass of the device with the remaining sand was recorded. The mass of the sand in the base plate and funnel, MS, was then calculated. The process was repeated up to 3 times and the average MS was obtained as the calibrated mass of the Ottawa sand in the base plate and funnel. Next, obtaining the calibrated Ottawa sand was performed. The filled sand cone device was placed over a mold. It was made sure that the mass and volume of the mold were obtained. The valve was opened, slowly filling the mold and funnel. Using the previous process, the mass of sand was obtained. The density of the sand was then calculated. The process was repeated 3 times and the average density was obtained as the calibrated density of the Ottawa sand.
After calibration, sand cone measurements were next performed. The test hole was excavated through the center of the base plate with the hole's shape approximately similar to the mold. The excavated soil was placed on a container to use for measurement of moisture content. Thank you. The sand cone device was filled with the Tawa sand and the mass of the field device was recorded. A portion of the soil was placed in a container. The moist mass of the soil excavated was also recorded. Denatured alcohol was poured in the container and was set on fire. Afterwards, the sand cone device was placed over the test hole. The tunnel valve was opened and the test hole, base plate and funnel was filled with sand. The volume of the test hole was next calculated. When the excavated soil and the cone was filled with the Tawa sand, the valve was closed and the mass of the apparatus with the remaining sand was measured. The mass of the sand used to fill the test hole, funnel, and base plate was then calculated. After all the alcohol evaporated, the dry mass of the soil was obtained. The moisture content was then calculated. Finally, the dry unit weight was calculated.